Thank you. Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Sophia Pereira, and I am the class president of the class of 2021. It is my great pleasure to welcome you all to as we celebrate the graduation of 388 of my classmates here at High School North. Would everyone please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance and stay standing for the national anthem? I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. You may be seated. Family, friends, and faculty and distinguished guests, but last, but certainly not least, the West Windsor-Plainsboro High School North Class of 2021. It is with immense pleasure and joy that I welcome you to the Cure Auto Arena, where these Northern Knights, seated before you, will soon walk across the stage to receive their diplomas and begin the next chapter of our lives. However, this moment would not have been possible without those of you in the audience. Parents, grandparents, siblings, aunts, uncles, cousins, friends, neighbors, and teachers. The list goes on and on. But one thing that has always reminded constant and never-ending love and support for us. For that, we will be forever grateful. And on behalf of the class of 2021, thank you all. The valedictorian is one of the most esteemed awards any person in high school can achieve, let alone at a school so academically challenging as High School North. It is a title that requires the utmost in scholarship, hard work, and commitment that is earned over the course of 4 years in full in high school. It is my pleasure to introduce the valedictorian of the class of 2021, Akhil Paul Raj.
Thank you so much, Sophie, for the introduction. Now, let me just start this off by establishing that I'll do my best to avoid saying the phrase unprecedented times or any other such COVID cliches today. You know, the trying times and new normals of the world. Still, I would be remiss if I did not underscore the pandemic as being a significant part of our identity as a class. When we think about the pandemic, we think about loss, even in the context of school alone. Loss of opportunity, loss of experience, loss of motivation, although that might have been inevitable anyways. Honestly, looking back, I don't see an educational experience where such loss was so apparent. I see positivity and optimism, a passion and energy that perhaps I hadn't appreciated before. Now, don't get me wrong, not too many of us are passionate about hearing the alarm go off at 7:40 in the morning, writing essays, or shoving pre-labs down our throats for lunch. But something that I believe all of us do indeed look forward to is what we do once the bell rings at 2:50. This year, we watched our academic teams compete and thrive in virtual settings. We admired the fiery passion of the WWP athletics community, demanding the opportunity for a season earlier in the year via our favorite friendly neighborhood Facebook group, and then in turn making the most out of the opportunities they received. We witnessed honorable efforts of volunteerism, we celebrated our accomplishments, and we nurtured the roots of our relationships across extracurricular interests, turning friendships into family. Now, this is where if I were a politician, I would say these acts are very American things to do, but as a student, I'll say they're very knightly things to do. What we achieved over these last 4 years would not be possible without the resources and community at North that enable us to do what we do. I'd like to thank North and the school district for their flexibility and understanding over the last year, starting with the lenient grading policies back in second sem junior year, the institution of screen-free days this year, and for signing us out of our Google accounts every 5 minutes to let us know our accounts are secure. Thanks to all my teachers over the last 12 years, special shout out to the A&E math program, especially Mr. Green during my time at Millstone, and of course, thanks to my friends and family for their encouragement and support. Now, I wanted to leave you all today with a message from the late, great Master Oogway, a quote that actually happened to resurface in our AP Lit Zoom chat. Oogway stated, "There are no accidents. It is no accident that we made the most out of school during the pandemic. It is similarly no accident that we are here today celebrating our achievements. Just like it is no accident that Ms. Hoyt was worried about her students playing Minecraft during class." Anyways, our success as a class, regardless of the circumstances we faced, is certainly no accident. It reflects our passion and values as Northern Knights. And I'm excited to see where our passions will take us out in the world. Thank you and go Knights.
The class speaker is selected by a committee of their peers, my fellow executive board members, to represent the entirety of graduates in the senior class. This honor traditionally goes to someone who reflects the high standards and positive ideals found in our graduates. Our class speaker this year is all of those things and many more. It is my pleasure to introduce the class speaker, Simhitha Raman.
Years ago, we felt both excitement and fright when we first became a Northern Knight. Upperclassmen were terrifying, as far as we could tell, and left us scrambling for a lunch table after the bell. Homecoming was the highlight of that fall, our first Spirit Week, leading up to a game of football. Vibrant superheroes covered the main hall. I kept my eyes wide open to take in it all. Exciting opportunities came near at the start of our sophomore year. In our peers, we placed trust and hope as we belayed and climbed rope. Traffic laws and signs, students studied with grit in hopes of finally carrying their own permit. We learned to left out a man our corner. Thank you for the amazing year, Mr. C and Mr. Warner. Soon, we traded gray attire for blue, hoping the infamous claims about junior year weren't true. With tests, labs, and projects on repeat, the library became the new place to eat. We battled through and did survive. Of course, we cannot forget those free 95s. Come this September, we knew it would be a year to remember. Lunchroom and study hall conversations were traded for mute and unmute buttons. But we are masters of going with the flow. Our own student council even created a virtual Tonight show. When faced with obstacles, we push through with all our might. That's what it means to be a Northern Knight. I wish you all futures filled with curiosity, exploration, and fun. Here's to the class of 2021. Thank you.
Our next speaker is someone that North simply couldn't live without. He spent countless hours making sure that our year could be as best as possible. What many don't know is that every Friday during lunch, he gave up his time to ensure that we could have a prom in our parking lot that worked as smoothly as possible. Without further ado, I'd like to introduce our principal, Dr. Dauber.
Thank you, Sophie. I think we're going to take a quick moment just to change gears a little bit, and we're going to listen to our High School North Chamber Choir has put together a musical interlude. So we're going to hear that first, and then I'll come back to speak. Sound good? Okay. Thank you.
Have changed. people and things that went before. I know I'll often stop and think about them. In my life, I love you
more. What's the saying? The saying is how lucky I am to have something so special that it makes saying goodbye so difficult. Good afternoon, seniors. Good afternoon. How are you?
Good.
Everybody good?
Yeah.
Okay. You can give me the nod of the head because I can't see through your masks, but we'll take you. It would be a mistake if I stood up here and I did not acknowledge the circumstances over the past 16 months. And although I do not wish to dwell on it, I did want to congratulate all of you, not only on your graduation, but also on your resilience, your sense of grit, as individuals and as a whole class, to rise above all of the challenges you have been presented with getting to this point here today, where for the first time in well over 1 year, we stand together united as the High School North Class of 2021. I was thinking about what to say to all of you when this occasion came to be a while back and how to build this speech. And if you've been paying attention, we've been together for a number of years. If you've been paying attention as to my educational foundations, if you will, they find a variety of philosophical themes or even buckets, perhaps, that include three things. Three things that I tend to compartmentalize within the greater picture. And they include, number one, this idea of success and failure, how they are related, what each of them means, and how they are both applied to your lives. Number two is the search of happiness, finding a sense of peace within yourself presently and within your lives over time. And finally, number three is a sense of purpose. Your role in this world, how you can contribute to the greater good. Now, it's common knowledge, depending upon who you follow in terms of literary works, but according to Mark Twain, the two most important days in all of your lives are number one, the day you are born, and number two, the day you figure out why. As it relates to purpose, it really doesn't matter who you are, what your GPA is, or what institution of higher learning that you may be heading to in the future. You need to understand that each of you has something to give, something to offer the greater community, the greater world. I hope you understand that each of you has the power to create change, to make life better for yourselves and for other people, because life is not so much about what you have. It's not about how much you have. It's about what you do with what you have. Allow yourselves to be defined not by the physical things that you desire, the symbols of status. Be instead defined by your willingness to embrace life, your openness to new opinions and new ideas, the risks you will take, the lessons you will learn from adversity, the people you will come to know, and the relationships that you will carry, if you are lucky, for the rest of your lives. I'd say to all of you graduates, at times, young people live in a state of mind where they are waiting for their real lives to begin. They're waiting to be part of or to enter the real world, with a presumption that life does not really start until sometime, anytime in the future, after college, for example. Real life itself does not require a diploma or 4 years from now, a college degree. Because this, to all of you, my students, this is your real life, and it has begun. Don't be mistaken. As life unfolds, I ask each of you not to aspire to simply make a living. I ask each of you instead to aspire to make a difference, recognizing that the things that will be essential in your lives are things that will be invisible to the human eye, things that will be impossible to quantify in any way. As I've said in the past, the world needs brilliant, committed people to support progress in a variety of disciplines: science, technology, education, government, the list goes on and on. But within that, the world also needs brilliant, committed people that are willing to, as my colleague, Mr. James Earle, seated behind us, has said earlier this week, people who are willing to live the work as per humanity, as per equity, as per equality, ethics, morality, patience, acceptance, kindness, love. Not do the work that needs to be done, but live the work that needs to be done at home, in our communities, and across the globe in faraway places. If we didn't realize it before, I am hopeful that we do now, or that we soon will in the very near future, that our humanity is what unites us, and that, my friends, is stronger than any differences that could possibly divide us. Almost 30 years ago, I was told, and I believed, and I still do, that there is nothing wrong with our world that cannot be fixed by what is right with our world. And all of you here today, graduates, class of 2020, this school, you are all shining examples of what is right with our world. So live your lives with a deep sense of commitment to each other, while understanding and recognizing not only your ability to make change, but your responsibility to make change and make the world better for everyone. Because as the timeless local rocker from Freehold, New Jersey, you've never heard of him, but his name is Mr. Springsteen. Parents might know who I'm talking about. But as Mr. Springsteen said to me 30 years ago, and pretty much anybody else who grew up in the 80s, I see Basio out there. There you go. As human beings, in the end, none of us win unless all of us win. Now, I wish not to see this moment as goodbye to all of you, but instead to see it as until we meet again. And I hope that you will keep all that is High School North, particularly the people who comprise it, close to you, close to your hearts, today and over the course of your lives. So on behalf of the West Windsor-Plainsboro community, our best wishes to all of you for a successful, happy, purposeful, and ultimately wonderful life. Congratulations. Now, for a little business at hand, the technical piece of your graduation, Dr. Adderhold, if you would please join me at the podium at this time. Dr. Adderhold, this year's class has truly, without a doubt, proven to be one of the absolute most outstanding, resilient, dedicated, committed groups of students to attend High School North, no matter what the platform is, all in, hybrid, or virtual. I continue to be inspired by their dedication to their studies, to our school, and to each other. They are bright, insightful, reflective young people who I am sure will go on to do many, many great things. With that, by the power vested in me by the state of New Jersey and the West Windsor-Plainsboro Regional School District, as the principal of High School North, I can certify, dignify, and testify that these students have met the requirements for graduation as identified by the New Jersey Department of Education. And to that end, I hereby formally present to you as the superintendent of schools, as well as to the Board of Education, the West Windsor-Plainsboro High School North graduating class of 2021.
Good afternoon. Members of the Board of Education, distinguished members of the community, members of the faculty, parents, family, and friends, and members of the class of 2021. Based upon the certification and recommendation of Dr. Dauber that the class of 2021 has met the requirements established by the state of New Jersey and the West Windsor-Plainsboro Board of Education, it's my great honor to accept the high school class of 2021. Now, graduates, graduation day is an opportunity to pause in reflection of an achievement well earned. However, this year graduation also feels a bit wonderful, more like a community reunion, a homecoming of sorts. And as more opportunities for celebration and gatherings have occurred these past few weeks, they have served as a reminder and an opportunity to reconnect with friends and classmates, neighbors and colleagues. To the members of our school community, to our parents, our students, members of the faculty, I'd like to extend my gratitude to all of you and to our West Windsor and Plainsboro communities. The care and concern that you have shown to one another these past 16 months has been heartwarming. Now, graduates, I think I can safely say that the past 16 months have tested us all. As we gather today amidst a raging global pandemic, we find ourselves joined together in celebration with renewed hope for the way things were and a view of how things can be moving forward, a proverbial return to normal. And while today is a day for graduation, celebration, and gatherings with family and friends, the students graduating today should be commended for so much more than making it to an academic finish line at graduation. Throughout your time in West Windsor-Plainsboro High School North, you have shown us that there was nothing normal about the way things were before the pandemic. The truth is that every generation builds upon and brings forth change and builds on the legacy of the prior generations. The students graduating before us have advocated for and brought forward changes grounded in environmental policies and sustainability. You have advocated for human rights, protested gun violence after Parkland, participated in Black Lives Matter demonstrations, advocated for LGBTQIA plus community, focused upon women's rights, advocated for mental health awareness, and you have staunchly advocated for a diverse, inclusive, and just school community. You have raised funds for victims of hurricanes, floods, fires, and earthquakes. You've supported local food banks at the Plainsboro Pantry and Homefront. The truth is, you've made us tremendously proud over and over again. And as you graduate from West Windsor-Plainsboro today, I ask you that you take and you build upon your passions and you use them to advocate for causes in which you are passionate. The pandemic has provided us all an opportunity to refocus and pause and reflect upon what we most hold most dear and important. And while these past 16 months have been at times extremely difficult and somewhat isolating, they've also provided us with an opportunity to see the beauty of humanity, the resolve of the human spirit, the preservation of innocence, the importance and a belief in science, and the determination of communities committed to a common cause and to one another. To the parents in the arena today, I offer you my congratulations, not just on the graduation of your children before you, but on guiding your graduate through the challenges and hardships of these past few months, and for providing them and guiding them forward in a pursuit of their passions and their dreams. Your love and guidance has supported them through these trying times, and their journey has been forever strengthened by your grace, your love, and your guidance. To our graduates, as you reflect on all that you have accomplished and all that you have overcome, you have persevered and you have grown forward with strength and dedication and an unyielding determination. I ask that you think about your legacy, think about the contributions that you want to make. What will the gifts be that you leave upon this world? Your path forward is bright. Be proud in all that you have accomplished and all that you will contribute. Always remember to advocate for causes in which you are passionate. Continue to make a commitment to the communities in which you live, organizations to which you serve, and friends and family to whom you love. Class of 2021, you have made us proud. Job well done. Best of luck. Go forth and make a difference in this world. Best wishes on your journey. It's now my honor and privilege to welcome to the podium the Board of Education President, Michelle Kaish.
I'm honored to be here, speaking on behalf of the Board of Education and celebrating the achievements of the West Windsor-Plainsboro High School North Class of 2021. After more than a year of cancellations and quarantines, we are extremely grateful to be together today, sharing in your excitement as graduating seniors and in the tremendous pride of your teachers, families, and friends. The class of 2021 will undoubtedly be remembered as among the most famous in school history. Throughout your life, you will have a unique story to tell about the events of your junior and senior years. The last 15 months have been challenging and difficult for everyone, but for you and your families, we recognize it has been particularly hard. Please know that we share in your feelings of disappointment from missed experiences and opportunities. While we cannot give you back those once-in-a-lifetime moments, we can acknowledge it hurts. Navigating high school in WWP is demanding. A global pandemic makes it exponentially so. But no life path is a straight line, and hurdles will always be part of your journey. Challenging times teach us empowering lessons, and you, class of 2021, have had a crash course. Even in the most stressful times, you can find small lights in the dark. You know how your parents and grandparents always like to talk about how when they were kids, they walked 5 miles to school every day in the rain and snow, uphill both ways? Yeah, well, that's nothing. There will come a time when you get to tell the stories about the year you struggled to figure out which hybrid day it was when every day was Blur's day. You will smile when you recall attending school from your bed and not knowing what asynchronous meant. And you will fondly reminisce about the good old days when your gym activity was a TikTok dance challenge and your part-time job was providing tech support for your teachers and your parents. Despite the demands of virtual or hybrid or all-in learning, or maybe because of them, as students in WWP, you have acquired tools for lifelong learning and the ability to make meaning of the world around you. As you exit high school and get on the ramp that will lead you to whatever is next, I hope you remember to take direction from your moral compass. Chart your own course and turn obstacles into opportunities. Don't look down on anyone unless you are helping them up. Strive to be thoughtful and loyal and to leave the world a little better than you found it. Take actions that embody kindness and take notice of others that do too. And enjoy the little things, because one day you may look back and realize they were the big things. People reach their full potential when encouraged to believe it is possible. On behalf of the Board of Education, I want to congratulate you all and wish you the best of luck moving forward. Make us proud, class of 2021. We believe in you.
Snehit Achanta. Abhinav Acharya. Nana Achempong. Adina Asfan. Michelle Agarwal.
Yeah, Michelle!
Sharia Agarwal. Ashley Agiolotti. Yusuf Ahmed. Daniel Ajay. Panishri Akshanthula. Afreen Alam. Thea Albin. Nysa Alexander. Xavier Alicia. Anushka Anand. Maxwell Anklowitz. Shreya Anapuru. Afa Asante. Anushka Aswin. Layanga Athena Ladana. Emily Au. Siddharth Balaji. Sonia Balakrishnan. Pranay Balyan. Ahana Banerjee. Niyati Bantwal. Sarika Bapat.
Yes, Sarika!
Shruti Bapatla. Sophia Barbatsuli. Michael Bell. Rhea Bembe. Isaac Berger. Aaron Besser. Surya Bharadwaj. Kashish Bhargavaj. Isita Basin. Yeah. Mahasna Bantnagar. Caleb Birnbaum. Ryan Boev. Rohan Bora. Spandana Bandalapati. Anna Bonfim. Juliana Bonfrisco. Devshree Botwe. Alex Bronze.
Yeah, Alex.
David Bryan. Rithika Busaretti. Donovan Butler. Kevin Cow. Ramon Casado. Joshua Chait. Akash Chaka. Lauren Chan. Viraj Chandra. You're good. Rajiv Chatterjee. Eddie Chen. Kelly Chen. Catherine Chun. Caitlin Chung. Ryan Clark. Asquith Clark. Sean Corriero. Caroline Corvo.
Yeah, Caroline!
Jennifer Cortez. Nzinga Cottle. Aaron Cruz. Jennifer Cruz. Ashley Chu. Sorry, Jose Cruz. Ashley Chu. Shanuk Dagalar. Benjamin Diagnalti. Ian Damianov.
Yeah, Ian! Woo!
Akshit Dandermaju. Crosby Davidson. Julius Deegan. Brian Delk.
Leah Dempsey. Shiv Desai. Brian DeSalvo. Ishida Deshmukh.
Yeah, Ishi!
Vidi Dolakia. Muhammad Diagne. Christina Diaz. Matthew DiPietro. Chet Dogra. Alec Duty. William Dory. Brandon Drayton. Naya Drayton. Shukruti Dubaganta. Titania Dogra. Anish Durai. Thomas Dury. Archie Dyke. Anastasia Alfar. Shukruti Enaredi. Shrujana Enaredi. Justin Epstein. Lila Escobar. Janae Utse. Mikhail Fabius.
Yeah, Mickey.
Lawrence Fisher. Miles Hall. Stephanie Fuses. Sarab Gadre. Aurora Gallagher. Joyce Gahn. Herschel Ganapati.
Yeah, Herschel.
Hershini Ganapati.
Yeah, Hershini.
Kaushik Ganapali. Thomas Gardner. Frank Geckvie. Akshay Gandakota. Kamaya Gillette. Savon Gofan. Adam Golbin. Hannah Goldschmidt. Justin Gong. Gauri Govindaraj. Ignor Garawal. Maya Gunasilan.
Yeah, Maya.
Kyle Guo. Asta Gupta. Nikita Gupta. Rohan Gupta. Christopher Hall. Kaya Hall. Sarang Hadagali.
Yes, Sarang! Yeah.
Miles Hall. Kareem Hamad. Shamila Huck.
Yes, Shamila.
Noor Hassan. Rashad Hassan. Ivor Hovkin. Max Havlicek. Shreya Hegde. Naomi Ho. Madeline Holmes. Yeah. Benjamin Hughes. Sahana Ayer. Devin Jackson. Nikita Jane. Anave Jameson. Hope Jaworowski. Laura Jean-Baptiste. Isabella Jiang. Raymond Jin. Kristen Joe. Shreyas John. Jaysana Jones. Jader Joseph. Shannon Joseph. Manas Joshi. Shreya Joshi. Ryan Jun.
Jiwook Jung. Suraj Ketchum. Arnav Kakarla. Darren Kalei. Parth Kale. Ankita Kamadi. Sahithi Kamineni. Sophia Candelin. Ajit Kandasamy. Benjamin Cantor. Ashrita Katakam. McKenna Katz. Steven Kalmanovich.
Yeah, Steven.
Disha Kohli. Grace Kolker. Nicholas Kolker. Sanjana Korpal. Yana Kasukin. Ranjini Krishnan. Lauren Kuzmarski. Anitya Kumar. Pranav Kumar.
Yeah, Pranav.
Rohit Kundu. Ian Kwok. Kyle Landy.
Yeah, Kyle.
Max Lasky. Congratulations. Irene Lee. Mackenzie Leung. Sid Kawaramani. Stella Lee.
Yes, Stella!
Travis Lee. Laura Liao. Joseph Lilywhite. Caleb Liu. Daniel Liu. Jeffrey Liu. Angelina Lopez Alvarez. Catherine Liu. Imogen Lubin. Annie Ma. Pranav Mahablishwalker.
Yes, Pranav!
Austin James Malabunga. Trisha Malhotra. Ankitha Malikov. Siddhant Main. Karuna Mangapudi. Sri Tulasi Manipali. Sai Manakanda. Maya Mao. Cassandra Medina. Archit Mehta. Ishva Mehta. Jill Mehta. Palak Mehta. Micah Melville. Sahir Mir. Lindsay Mitchell. Ashley Moritz. Amreen Mukadam. Makut Mukherjee. Sneha Mukherjee. Ruthvik Mukamala. Rohit Mukund. Heather Murphy. Manal Mustafa. Anish Nagareddy. Akhil Nagulupalli. Vishal Naidu. Rhea Nair. Paranita Natial. Ina Nagoyu. Sonia Nindra.
Brendan O'Connell. Vaibhav Ori. Daniel Orozco. Benjamin Palmer. David Pan. Vivek Panchagnula. Shreya Pandey. Ishan Pandya. Richa Parikh. Arya Patel. Rishi Patel. Akhil Polraj. Queen. Alexa Pedley. Thomas Pelosi. Congrats. Divya Pendiala. John Perla. Isabella Petroselli. Madison Phillips. Sarah Pierre. Nathan Pereira. Sophia Pereira. Yeah.
Shreja Polkampoli. Ayush Prakash. Vaishnavi Pratha. Anushka Purkayastra. Sei Purohit. Lionel Quaynor, sorry. Dia Rai. Aditya Rajesh. Anvith Ramadugu. Krishna Ramamurthy. Shashmita Ramamurthy. Samita Raman. Mateo Ramdani Jury. Sancharita Ramji. Rupal Randhawa. Panav Rastogi. Priyanshu Rathi. Natuli Ratnayak. Keshav Rathra. Shinjini Ray. Usher Rehan. Yusuf Riyad. Olivia Richardson. Hayden Robertson. Jalen Robinson. Alex Xavier Roman. Aiden Rossi. Matthew James Rojas. Nicholas Ryan. Mira Savin. Hannah Safranoff. Brian Tsai. Ankita Samal. Vaibhav Sanjay. William Santa Maria. Rhythm Satav. Ananya Satish. William Selick. Srishti Sen. Sriram Senthil. Ananya Seshadri. Arsha Shah. Dhruv Shah. Shaina Shah. Amish Sheikh. Parth Sharma. Shivank Sharma. Tisha Sharma. Yeah. Vanya Sharma. Parth Shastri. Niall Sheriff. Divit Shetty. Evelyn Xiao. Yash Srivastava. Shweta Sinde.
Yes, Shweta!
Tejas Sin. Rahul Sinha. Soham Sinha. Jacob Slater. Anjali Smith. Kavya Soleil. Kayla Solari.
Yeah, Kayla.
Olivia Solis.
Yes, Olivia!
Jonathan Solomon.
Yes,
Samantha Spector. Akash Srinivasan. Rebecca Starr. Miles Stokes. Mahika Survey. Vaidish Swaminathan. Tagaram. Ishida Taparia. Sharvari Tadachar. Akshay Tiwari. Alan Tong. Tanush Tripathi. Arunima Tripathi. Ishida Tripathi. Danielle Sang. David Tunis. Mame Twamburima. Nana Twamburima. Matthew Usequin. Anirvan Vadiyar. Vivek Vijaypay. Nikhil Velakutla. Tyler Vandenberg. Yashwant Velen. Abhiram Velour. Vignesh Venkat. Aryan Vij. James Vincent. Sonia Bora.
Yes, Sonia!
Sathvika Vupala. Sharanya Vutla. Daniel Wang. Ethan Wang. Justin Wang. Shine Wang. Taylor White. Max Weiner. Fallon Wilcox. Jasmine Williams. Phoenix Williams.
Yeah, Phoenix!
Dewan Wilson. Michael Wu. Sophia Shu. Charlie Yang. Ryan Yang. Alex Yao. Leo Yao.
Yay, Leo!
Claire Yu. Lauren Yuan. Albert Zhang. John Zhang. Marilyn Zhang.
Yeah, Marilyn!
Victoria Zhang.
Yeah, Victoria, so double. Yeah, yeah.
Jimmy Zhen.
Yay, Jimmy!
Yeah, Jimmy.
Yeah, Jimmy.
Oliver Zong.
Yeah, Oliver.
Cassidy Zhuang.
Yes, Cassidy!
John J. Zigane.
Yeah, John J.
Isabella Zodell. And Tommy Zovich.
Yes,
Woo!
Hello again. For months, I've been trying to come up with the perfect speech for perhaps the most important day of our lives thus far. But I didn't seem to have any words. I had a lot of thoughts, but not a lot of words, which is rare for me. But perhaps that's a good thing, because it opened my mind to doing something a little bit different, much like what we all had to do this year. So I decided, what if I do one giant story time for old time's sake? I want to talk about a moment, or rather a day, that I think is most representative of our high school experience. This is going to be a detailed story, or as my family would call it, a Sophie story, but stick with me. It's Friday, June 4th, 2021, just 2 short weeks ago. The days leading up to June 4th were filled with opening the weather app, opening the radar, screenshotting both, then sending screenshot after screenshot to each other of the impending doom of the uncertain summer thunderstorms that were going to strike on our prom night, our one and only prom. For many, it felt like the world was against us. Would we be allowed to have a prom? Would we be allowed to have, would we have to move to the cafeteria? What would happen to pictures? Would they get rained out? Finally, it's prom day. After a few sleepless nights, and the weather forecast is saying thunderstorms all night, prom is going to have to move indoors. Last-minute change of plans meant scrambling to make sure that everything runs smoothly. It's 1:09 p.m., and I'm on my way to get my hair done when I get a call from Ms. OJ and Ms. Julius. The weather looks like it might actually go our way. Prom is back outside. The news breaks, group chats are blowing up with excitement. Everything was going according to plan. 3:37, the sky gets dark while everyone is getting ready for the night we've all been waiting for. And then the storms hit. It felt like doomsday. It rained, but there was still hope. The storm passed, the rain was gone, but the sky was still gray. The grass wet and the air a little humid. Perhaps it was like a little bit what the beginning of this year felt like. Hopeful, but a little uncertain. Around 5:05 p.m., people began to get ready to face the ick and take pictures despite the gray-faced sky. When the unimaginable happens, the sun decided to show its face, brighter than we'd seen in days. The humidity went away, and the temperature was just right. It became the perfect evening. We gathered together for our first and final hurrah as high school students before we graduate. We danced, we laughed, and we were family, reunited after a long year. So what does this have to do with graduation? What does this have to do with our class? It's a reminder that the sun will always shine again. As a class, we have faced more than the average high school student. We've spent more than a year apart, most of us black boxes on a small Zoom screen. We were the first class to apply to college, tour colleges, and decide whether or not we wanted to go to college, or perhaps decide what our future was going to be, all from the four walls of our homes. Looking further back, we were the first class to pick up Chromebooks, an exciting but strange experience. We were the first class to take the park exam. I know, everybody's favorite. The first to not have to take the SAT to apply to college. The first to have to sign into study hall. We faced a pandemic together. We faced social injustice together. And we faced one of the hardest things of all together, simply growing up. And now, for the first time in over a year, we are all together again. The statement of the year, and of course, everybody's favorite High School Musical quote, "We're all in this together," has finally come true. I am so, so proud of you, Knights. Everyone in this room is proud of you. Your resilience, your passion, your kindness, your compassion, and determination is admirable. I have never met a group of people more ready to take on the world, to use their voice, to stand up for what they believe in, to stand up for what is right. A group of people who, when they get knocked down, come back 10 times stronger. You should be proud of yourselves for everything you have accomplished, all of your successes and your failures, all of the happy moments and all of the less happy moments. This year has taught us that nothing goes according to plan, and that no matter how much we plan for the future, it always has its own path for us. It has taught us to remember that the people in this room are some of the only people who have experienced the same things as us. That's what makes us Knights. That's what makes us a family. And stay connected, because there's nothing that heals better than a little conversation. Finally, remember that the sun will always shine again. Thank you for everything, Knights. I love you. And for one last time, can I get a yeah, Knights? Yeah. Will my fellow members of the class of 2021 please rise? As we formally step into the next chapter of our lives, we must first complete our high school journey with a symbolic turning of the tassel, signifying our movement from high school student to high school graduate. So get your tassels on the right, get ready. On the count of three, we will turn our tassels from right to left in unison. Are we ready, Knights?
Yeah.
I can't hear you. Are we ready, Knights?
Yeah.
Ready? One, two, three. Congratulations, Knights, we did it. Throw those caps in the air.
Thank you.